sometimes in your formulas, you need to write a particular expression repeatedly. This makes your formulas long and fairly difficult to understand. In this example on screen, we've written the match expression twice. This makes the formula long and it takes twice the number of resources to calculate the same expression of match. Let function in Excel lets you write variables in your formula. This can remove the need to write the same expression again and again. Let's look at two examples of let function. Let's look at the first example. We have the sample data for sales in a year. In case the total sales for the year are more than 65,000, then a 10% bonus should be awarded. The challenge is simple. We need to find the sum, and using an if statement, we can check if it is more than 65,000. If it is, we can give the bonus, else no. So the formula we will write is if. Logical test will be the sum of total sales, that is B2 to B13, is greater than 65,000. If that is true, then the bonus is 10% of the total sales. Therefore, sum of B2 to B13 into 10%. And for value if false, it will be 0 or no bonus. Now if you notice, the expression sum B2 to B13 appears twice. Using let, we can capture the result of this expression in a variable and use the variable multiple times. This way, the calculation of sum B2 to B13 will only be done once, thus saving resources. This is a simple example, but in real life, the calculations could be over thousands of rows. So let's start by writing let. Hit Alt plus Enter if you are on a Windows machine, or hit Shift Command Enter if you are on a Mac to go to the next line. It is a common practice to write the formula in different lines while using let. This helps in understanding the formula better. The first parameter is name 1. We need to define a variable name. Since we are using the total of the sales value repeatedly, we can call the variable as total. It helps if you give meaningful names. As you press comma, it expects a definition of the variable. The variable total is for the sum of the values B2 to B13. After this, we can define more variables or define the calculation. We can proceed with the calculation definition as there are no more variables to define. We will first go to the next line using Alt Enter or Shift Command Enter. We will start with if. For logical test, we can check if total is greater than 65,000. If that's true, then for value if true, we can say total multiplied by 10%. Else the bonus is 0. Now if you look at the formula, we're only calculating the sum once, thus saving some resources and making the formula more readable. So this was a simple example of let. Let's look at another one. We have a list of salespeople who were the top sellers for the week. We have this data for 6 months or 26 weeks. We need to display the names of all the salespeople who were on this list at least once. And then we also need to write the award category next to their names. If they were on the list 7 or more times, then display gold against their name. If they were on the list 5 or 6 times, then display silver, else display none against their names. So let's first display the names of the salespeople who have their name on the list. To do that, we will use the unique function. In the cell D2, we will write unique. The array will be B2 to B27, where we have all the names. We get these 5 names, which means these people were on the list at least once. Now we need to identify the award category. We will write let. Next line, Let's define a variable count, which will contain the count of how many times the name appears on the list. To provide a value to the variable count, we will use a countifs function. The criteria range is the list of names from B2 to B27. The criteria starts from D2. Since the list returned by unique is dynamic, we will use hash to spill the range from D2 till the last value. For the calculation, we will write a simple if statement. If the count is greater than or equal to 7, then the award category is gold. In value if false, we will check if the count is greater than or equal to 5, then the award category is silver. Else we will write none. Close the bracket for both the if statements and let function. And we get the result for our values. Now to quickly check, I'm going to copy this countifs part from this formula and paste it in the next column. As you can see, Jim has got the award 5 times. That is why the category is silver. And Roy has got the award 7 times. That's why the category is gold. Maria has got it 6 times. That is why her category is silver. Ravi and Paula have got this award less than 5 times. That's why none. So that is how you use the let function. We've seen how to use it in simple ranges as well as dynamic ranges. If you found this tutorial helpful, make sure to give it a thumbs up. Leave a comment with any questions or topics you'd like us to cover. And don't forget to subscribe our channel, Analytics Success, for more tips and tricks on Excel and data analytics. Thanks for watching.